North Korean state-sponsored cyber actors are attacking U.S. healthcare and public health sector organizations since at least May 2021. These incidents disrupted the services provided by the targeted health sector organizations for prolonged periods. Compared to other ransomware attacks, Maui ransomware is believed to be designed for manual execution by attackers. Fortunately, there are steps that organizations can take in order to prevent these types of attacks from impacting their systems in the future. This analysis comes from our own security expert, Dušan Trojanović. All resources and links are available in the description. Let's dive into this attack. The FBI, CISA, and the Department of Treasury released a joint cybersecurity advisory to provide information on Maui ransomware, which is claimed to have been used by North Korean state-sponsored cyber actors since at least May 2021 to target healthcare and public health sector organizations. In June 2022, the Stairwell research team investigated one of the lesser-known ecosystems of ransomware as a service, in this case, the Maui ransomware. Maui has been shown to have a lack of several key features which are commonly seen in ransomware as a service tools and providers, such as an embedded ransom note to provide recovery instructions or automated means of transmitting encryption keys to attackers. Instead, Stairwell believed that the Maui team is manually operated, in which operators will specify which files to encrypt when executing it, and then exfiltrate the resulting runtime artifacts. Security awareness also promotes a heightened level of attention to the subtle activities performed by a threat actor, who has the objective of illegally obtaining your data or to damage your corporate resources. Since May 2021, the FBI has observed and responded to multiple Maui ransomware incidents. North Korean state-sponsored cyber actors use Maui ransomware in these incidents to encrypt servers responsible for healthcare services, including electronic health record services, diagnostic services, imaging services, and intranet services. In some cases, these incidents disrupted the services provided by these health organizations for prolonged periods. The initial access vectors for these incidents are unknown. However, the earliest identified copy of Maui, the SHA-256 hash, which is provided here, was first collected by Stairwell's Inception team platform on April 3, 2022. Maui is believed to be designed for manual execution by attackers. When executed at the command line without any arguments, Maui prints usage information detailing supported command line parameters. The only required argument is a folder path, which Maui will parse and encrypt identified files. Instead of relying upon external infrastructure to receive encryption keys, Maui creates three files in the same directory it was executed from, unless a custom log directory is passed using the p command line argument, containing the results of its execution. These files are likely exfiltrated by Maui operators and processed by private tooling to generate associated decryption tooling. Indicators of compromise obtained from FBI incident response activities since May 2021 are provided here. Maui uses a combination of advanced encryption standards, RSA and XOR encryption, to encrypt targeted files. Maui encrypts targeted files with AES 128-bit encryption. Each encrypted file has a unique AES key, and each file contains a custom header with the file's original path, allowing Maui to identify previously encrypted files. The header also contains encrypted copies of the AES key. Maui encrypts each AES key with RSA encryption. Maui loads the RSA public, maui.key, and private, maui.evd, keys in the same directory as itself. Maui encodes the RSA public key, maui.key, using XOR encryption. XOR key is then generated from hard drive information. While Maui is encrypting files, it outputs status information back to operators. Command line output during the execution is available here. Fortunately, the advisory also provides mitigation steps organizations can take to prepare for or deal with attacks using Maui ransomware. Although Maui may be a little bit different from your run-of-the-mill ransomware attacks, the steps to protect against them are not, which include maintaining off-site, offline backups of data and testing them regularly, creating a cybersecurity response plan, keeping operating systems, applications, and firmware up to date at all times, disabling or hardening remote desktop protocols, requiring multi-factor authentication for as many services as possible, requiring administrative credentials to install software, and then finally reporting ransomware incidents to your local FBI field office. We hope that this video will guide you to the recent attack and give you good advice on how to protect your organization in the future. Of course, the best advice that can always be given is to keep your systems and services updated as soon as they are available. Did you find value in this video? If so, like and subscribe for more content. Or drop a comment below and tell us which attacks you'd like our experts to cover next.